You walk with me through fire. Heal my disease. I trust in
Welcome to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggy. And tonight we have Nancy Allensworth from Michigan and Butch McKeen. And so we've just had a really good time this last couple weeks. And one of the things I do want to announce right away is that we're doing a spiritual gifts conference this weekend. It'll be in Ankeny, Iowa. And we have different guests that are coming to speak and some that are local. And it's going to be a great time just talking about what all the gifts of the spirits, how to operate in them. We're going to have a classroom style. We're going to have people get up and demonstrate, and then people do it. We want people to know how to do it.
Well, everybody talks about them, but nobody demonstrates them. You know, it's like having a toolbox with tools that nobody knows how to use. It's time we grow up and show people how to use the different tools that God gives us.
Amen. So we've got all kinds of people that are excited about it, and they want to know how to use the gift. They've, you know, we've taught a lot of people around here in different places how to walk in healing ministry, but we want them to know how to use all the gifts of the Spirit too. So, you know, it can just help you when you're walking around in some place and you see somebody and you get a word of knowledge, then you know that's what it is. So it can help you to help them. It just makes such a big difference when we know, because some people actually have done it, but they just don't even get that that's from God. And so we want people to just be able to do all that God has for them, to use all the gifts.
We had a minister just, well, Lila, she's not here tonight. She's got some other things going on. She said, well, I can't do that. Just fear come on. I said, well, you've already done them all. I have not. And I said, well, have you ever spoken tongues? She said, yeah. Have you ever spoken tongues and interpreted? Yeah. Did you ever have discernment, whether it come from heaven or hell? Yeah. Did you ever have a word of knowledge, a word of wisdom? Did you ever prophesy? Did you ever exercise faith? Did you ever get a miracle?
Amen.
Did you ever get a healing? Yeah. Yeah, to all of them. I said, well, that's all nine gifts.
Amen.
How hard was that? You've already done it all.
Yep. Praise God.
And all you got to do is share a testimony. And most times when you share a testimony of that, it just duplicates. And it was kind of funny. We were going to Minnesota, and I wasn't going to eat supper late. 9:30 at night, I knew there was a Burger King right up by the state line.
Hey, Maddie, can you find that video?
And I just had to have a cheeseburger. I like beef. And I went in, went to the bathroom, and I walked up, and I'm kind of reading this lady's mail, and she says, how you doing? Oh, you don't really want to know, do you? I said, yeah, I want to know. Oh, I'm having a really bad day. Not enough people come in. And, you know, I'm getting old for running around. We've been making them young kids look slow because we've had to really hustle. And I grabbed her hand and just said life, and all the pain left her body. She got healed of, what, four different things on the film? Mm-hmm. Didn't even know what it was. And she started confessing things. She was having a bad day. She was out taking her break, and she was praying that God would answer her prayer. And we found out that was the same time that I had to have a cheeseburger.
It's on
Dave's. I never
Dave's.
Did get a cheeseburger. Yeah, well, actually I did. I got that 2 for $5.
Yeah.
It was a Big King instead of a cheeseburger.
But it was so cool. And we stopped on the way back, too. We just had to see how she's doing. And we stopped, and she told us when we walked off, she goes, you guys have to come back more often. Well, we live in Iowa, so we don't come here very often. But so we stopped on the way back, and it's on Dave's Facebook. And so it was so funny because we walked up, and me, Dave, and Lila, and she just looks at us. She's like, oh, like, there they are again. She did recognize us right away. And she said that she's not in pain anymore. That, you know, it'd been, what, Friday night, and we came back through Sunday afternoon, and she said she still didn't have any pain, and we're like, yes, you just keep it. So it was so cool because she was so excited and just talking about God. And just then some other customers came, so we had to go. But, okay, Maddie's got that up. Thank you, Maddie. It's so neat.
Jesus.
Amen. The way that he would have me do with compassion and love. And I tried to remember grace and forgiveness and not say a bad thing about anybody. I just, and this man just touched me. And I feel like I'm 25 again. Amen. Oh, yeah.
So you had pain before?
I had herniated disc, fibromyalgia, osteoarthritis, and I feel wonderful.
Thank
so
God.
You need to stop in here more often, man.
Hey, next weekend we're going to have a conference in Hickenay.
You come down there. Can you tell us your name?
Annie Haraldson. I'm okay. From Minnesota, and I work in Iowa, but I got to take this call and drive through, okay?
Okay, thank you. God bless. You know, it's just so cool when you get the videos, because then you get to see what really happened. So, Annie, thank you. And we're just blessed that we ran into her and that she was healed. So it seems like wherever we go, we find people. There was somebody at the restaurant we went to Sunday morning. It was right after 11, so we went Subway to get breakfast.
Well, what happened first? Why were we late? What did we do Sunday morning? Saturday morning. How did we start our day? We were on the radio of another.
Oh, okay. You're on Monday or Saturday. Yeah, we were on a radio show on Saturday morning, and it's on our Facebook too, so you can click on it and go back to it. Reverend Stan, I can't remember, it's a blog talk radio thing.
He's from Hickory, North Carolina. He networks a lot of different ministries. They want us to come down. I think it was June or July. They're setting up a big conference.
Yeah.
And July. He interviewed, you know, not everybody's been to heaven and back a couple times like me. So he wanted to know about that and share that with his listeners, and they wanted to have us come down and demonstrate. Then we got into the conference we're in, and then they said, hey, just go 2 miles down, grab something and come back so we can all minister during lunch.
Yep.
So I hang with some pretty radical people. It was Matthew Goers. We're like brothers.
Yep, he was with.
And I said, stop. I jumped by the car, and he thought I was going to use the restroom or something. So they go with Patty and them go to the drive-thru. I ran to the door because I seen a lady headed there with a cane, and I didn't open the door up far enough, but I reached out my hand. I got a hold of her. I said, you're in pain, aren't you? Watch this. Pain, you go. And she checked it out, and I ran around the building, and I got over to the side before they got their food. Lady got totally healed. They put her card in her hand.
Amen. So we should pull up some of those pictures. There's one at first with Tom Stammen, and Lila went with us, and then Barb came down, and then there's Matthew Goers on the right in the blue.
That's who I jumped out of his car at Culver's. We had a word of knowledge. The lady had a cane in her hand. Yep. Anytime you see somebody with a cane, you don't have to have a word of knowledge to know that there's something wrong.
Yeah, so there's Tom Stammen in the middle. He's with Impact Ministries International, and they feed orphans and widows in over 55 nations. And him and his wife, Teresa, they are just the busiest pastors we've ever met. Tom, he had last year, I think, 420 meetings in 1 year. Wow, yeah, obviously more than one a day.
And so, all the money he raises gets to the orphans.
Yep.
To build them buildings and homes and feed them. And he's got the number one orphanage in several of them nations, including Honduras.
Yeah, Honduras, he has a big one. He's trying to make it so they actually can set up to take care of themselves. They can live off the land. They have animals. And now they have a bakery, so they're making a
hardware store, a hotel. Mm-hmm. People are allowed to build their own little houses, so they come down there. Mm-hmm. He's making actually a city of refuge is what he calls it.
Yep. So he has prophetic meetings all over the country and in other nations too. And so invite Tom. He's a great guy. He takes care of widows and orphans. And he's on our commercial, our second set of commercials. We talk about his ministry on there. That's where Dave and I met at one of Tom's meetings, and we were married through Tom, and then he ordained us both. And he's ordained like 20 people that we have asked him to. So they have
including to. Including Butch.
Yeah, Butch. Praise God.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
So yep, there's Lila, Barb, and I, and there's Tom in the background. So Lila and Barb both got up and preached, and we were ministering to people at the end. And Tom says, you know, we need more of this. And it's like, yeah, we do. We do. We need to be able to minister healing and whatever God needs, whatever they need. So, and that lady, she was really having a hard time. She really got set free of a lot of sickness and pain and just I know a bunch of stuff just got knocked off of her. She was just so free by the time we were done ministering. It was just amazing what God did with her. Oh, there's Charlie.
Charlie had a hard time standing. The power of God hit him.
Oh, my gosh.
That started at about 5:30, and he was still shaking yesterday, this morning.
Even today. Today.
He's still getting shaken with the power of God. He's getting just transformed.
He sent me an email today and said, yeah, I'm still shaking under the power of God. So God's doing whatever it is that he needs. He's getting her done. So
Matthew's going to wonder about that.
There's Lila ministering to somebody. And the guy in the black behind the guy in the green there, he said he'd never felt the power of God. So we just kept blasting him. He finally did end up falling in the spirit. And then he got filled with the Holy Spirit, speaking in tongues. And I said, you know what that's about? He goes, yeah, my wife does it. And I'm like, okay, well, you need it too. So he got it. Praise God. Then he was ministering to Charlie too.
He got to feel the power of God come out of his hand. The Bible says if you lay hands on the sick, they will recover. But he just needed to get set free.
Yep.
So he got to see God use him right away.
That was neat. Yeah. Oh, that was at Famous Dave's. I didn't mean to put that one in there. Dave.
I was joking with the lady. I said, my name's Dave, and I didn't know they had these sparkler things. I said, I'd like one of them. Just kind of kidding around. So we're eating, and all of a sudden, what was there, 8, 9 people come?
Yeah.
Come and sang happy birthday to me. I couldn't tell them no because they already had the ice cream and stuff.
You know, usually people clap, and I just sat there. I was just like, oh, my gosh, I'm embarrassed.
And one of the other ministers actually had a birthday, so they got to do it to the other table with us. The cool thing is I stepped out and looked at my text, and I just found out I had a granddaughter.
Yeah.
She was just born.
Praise God.
So really, there was a birthday. It just wasn't mine.
I had no clue. Know.
I had no clue that was coming.
Yeah. So his youngest daughter, Amy and Nick, had a little baby girl, and she's precious. We got to go see her last night in the hospital. And one of my best friends for years, like 30 years, she had a baby, Lynn, the same time I had Grant. She had Bailey. They're just a day and a half apart. We were in the hospital at the same time. And her daughter had a baby girl yesterday. And so they were in Mercy Hospital when we were in Mercy Hospital with Dave's granddaughter. She was there with her daughter. So I thought that was really cool. I saw it on Facebook. I called her up. I'm like, I know you're in town. You wouldn't miss this. So I'm going to see her sometime this week and see that new baby girl. So congratulations, Bailey and your husband.
So. What have you been doing since we met you 3 weeks ago?
Or so.
Three weeks ago? Mm-hmm. So what's been happening in your life?
Every morning when I get up, I ask the Lord to give me opportunities, put people in my path.
Amen.
That I can minister to. And it's just, people are just right there. There's no mistake about the opportunities being there. I walk into the Meyer store. There is a 90-year-old lady who's a greeter. Mm-hmm. And I was talking with her, and she said that her knees were hurting. So I blasted her, and the pain went down some, and I blasted her a second time, and it went away.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah, that was really cool.
Yeah.
So we don't just teach you. We get you out getting results.
Yes.
Absolutely. We're kind of unusual people.
Praise God.
I love it, though.
So you've been meeting with some of the other ladies, going out with them, and just getting together. You've seen things happen in meetings in your homes, and you're just really going after it.
Yes, absolutely.
And one of your friends we prayed for shaked and baked for a couple of days, too. It's kind of like God just gets them on the cooker there and cooks them for a while.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and then after... the girl we're talking about, she'd been shaking for about a week.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
I
didn't know that.
Yeah. We had blasted her. It was like on a Monday night. And then the next morning, I texted her and asked her how she was doing.
Yeah.
And she said, I'm feeling great.
Amen.
Every once in a while, my body's still shaking. And then that Friday, I called her and asked her, you know, I said, so how long did that last? She says, I'm still shaking. And then I saw her again a couple days, the following Monday. And she was asking me about, when you pray for somebody, what do you say? And I pulled my chair up right in front of her, and I just took her hands and told her, you don't have to say anything. And she about fell out of her chair.
Praise God. Yeah, you don't. You just have to release the kingdom.
Yeah.
Does the Bible say lay hands and believe?
Absolutely.
It's the believing that makes it work. We're proud of you, and we're glad you came here.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah. She came to be with us. We have the Spiritual Gifts Conference next weekend, and it starts on Saturday. It's from 9 to 5. And then we're going to go out and about Saturday night at 7. So if you come to the conference, make sure you put in your schedule to go out, because we want to lay hands on the sick in public or just prophesy over people, whatever God gives us. We want people to actually do that too, not just sit in the training. Of course, we're going to have classroom stuff. They're going to be doing stuff in the training. But, yeah, come to the training at night too.
What happened to the lady you knew? I told her to prophesy over me at that really nice home with a John Deere tractor in the garage.
Susie?
Yeah, what happened when I had her prophesy over me?
the way that I described it to people was, it was kind of like she was giving birth.
Oh.
Just, you know, she was just, you know. And She got hit hard.
And I found that. I recorded that. So I have to send her a copy of that.
Oh, good. It's good to sometimes just send it to people so they know what they said, so they remember more about it, because they don't always remember everything.
Well, this is the key to keeping your healing. Immediately the devil comes to steal the word that was sown, the seed that was sown.
Yep.
And I can't believe how some people can get so deceived, like it's like the movie Groundhog Day. They go to sleep, wake up, and forgot it all happened. Oh, I must not be healed. I must not have said that. That's why we record, and we're slacking a little bit. We usually set up a camera in the corner somewhere when we're doing a home meeting, so everything's recorded, because there's some people that just have a hard time remembering what really happened.
Yeah, there's been times when I just knew right away the Holy Spirit told me to send it to him. I videotaped it, and I said, what's your email address? And I sent it right to him. So they can see themselves saying, all the pain's gone. Or the one lady was like, had a hard time seeing, and her vision all came back. And so I knew, with the Holy Spirit prompting me, that she needed to see herself saying those words on camera, and so that she could keep her healing. Because the devil, you know, he's sneaky. He hasn't changed. He tries to tell you that it's gone, that you never were healed. Well, when you see yourself saying, I'm healed, I can see, or the pain's all gone, then you can really grab a hold of it. So we want people to grab a hold of it and keep it. So we're going to go to a commercial, and then we'll be right back. Thank you, Maddie.
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
I'm Brian Leach, owner of Service Legends, and my position is Chief Talent Officer.
I'm Nicholas Wunderscheid.
I am Bernie Hobbs.
And I'm the Service Manager.
Marketing Director and Client Relations Manager.
Everything that we do is about ensuring that we exceed your expectations.
Our clients are important to us. 100% satisfaction.
We're not just focused on heating and cooling. That's the easiest part of our job, actually, is fixing furnaces and air conditioners.
Everyone that we come in touch with, we want to improve lives.
Bottom line is, we've got our installation guarantees, 25% energy savings guarantee, comfort guarantee, temperature selection guarantee, property protection guarantee.
100% satisfaction guaranteed, fixed rate or it's free.
All of those guarantees are backed up with a 100% money-back guarantee to hold ourselves accountable to making sure that you get what you're after.
Just fixing the problem today, if they have another problem 5 days down the road, it's still fixed rate or it's free.
We use what's called straightforward pricing. Our technicians are going to give you an exact to-the-penny price on what it's going to take before they move forward with any repair. That way you know what to expect.
It's the same price every day.
No surprises.
If you get off work at 5 o'clock in the afternoon, you come home, you realize that, oh, my furnace is broken. Now you need to call somebody out that night. You shouldn't have to pay more for that.
We're guaranteeing service 24/7.
We run afternoons, evenings, nights, weekends. We're staffed to work that.
Phone rings at 3 a.m. You'll get one of our representatives answering the phone every time.
We're not sending you out to Timbuktu in some call center. It's our Service Legend team members, our mission control team.
I'll take a call anytime.
And then they answer the phones same way during the day as they do at night.
It's a great day at your service company. How can we make you smile?
That's the only way to provide true 24-hour service.
When you're able to let somebody actually live in their home safely when they weren't able to do that before, where they don't have to stay up at night and worry about, is the heat going to come back on? Are we going to freeze the pipes? Is the baby in the room next door going to be sick because they got too cold? When you're able to help somebody overcome challenges like that, that's impacting a life. That makes a difference. I get goosebumps thinking about it.
I love the team. I love the people that I work with.
We have fun, but we work hard.
I call them my ambassadors of legendary service. If you could just envision what that is, that's who we're sending to your home.
They literally will call in, pick up the phone and call and say, hey, I want to talk to your manager. And I get on the phone, they're like, that technician that was at my house was the greatest technician ever. That's cool to me.
We want to brighten people's days.
Every person that we have going into the house has gone through an extensive background check.
Drug testing. We have a very thorough interview process that 1 out of 140 people make it through.
If we promise you something, that's what you're going to get, no matter what.
We're here when you need us to protect the safety and comfort of your family.
If you're not happy, we're going to make it right.
If we're willing to put 100% money-back guarantee on what we do, what type of work do you think we do?
Give us a call. We're there for you 24/7, 365 days a year.
Enough said.
Hello, friends. I'm Mike Politoski, president of the Spiritual First Responders. Would you like to learn how to heal the sick, how to actually lay hands on the sick and see them recover? I've written a training manual called the Spiritual First Responders Training Manual, and I'd like to see you get a copy of it. For any donation made to hslm.us for $15 or more, we will send you one of these training manuals, and you can learn how to lay hands on the sick and see them recover just as Jesus did in the days when he walked the earth. Endorsed by Dave and Patty, it's the Spiritual First Responders Training Manual. Thank you, and God bless you.
Hi there. Welcome back to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggy and Nancy Allensworth and Butch McKeen. Well, we've had an exciting week, and Nancy has some more testimonies from Michigan. So tell us what you've been doing.
I went and saw a friend that I hadn't seen for several months, and she's adopted a lot of kids, and I noticed one of the boys said that he was in pain, his back was hurting, and so I asked him to come here, and he came over to me, and then I called his brother over, and I asked his brother to put his hand on his back, and then I told him what to say.
Amen.
And all the pain was gone. And they were really surprised. And I just...
Why is it people are shocked when God keeps his word? You know, that just amazes me.
If that was my first time experiencing kids getting results.
Good for you.
Look how really much cool. You've grown in 3 weeks. We're so proud of you.
Amen. Amen.
You went from the student to the teacher, and now your students are getting results.
All right. Praise God.
Well, I told people that I had 3 days notice that you guys were coming to Michigan.
Yes.
And I said, it was a God thing for sure.
Yep.
And I'm so grateful.
Yeah. Well, we love seeing people healed all over, and Michigan led to Illinois first, and then Canada, and then Michigan again, and then Illinois again. And so it was
just again and again and again. Three Illinois.
Yeah. It was just a whirlwind. It started out as just a couple days, and God just went. So it's cool how God can do that.
When Dave came back with me to the Grand Rapids area, mm-hmm. there was a lady that I knew at the health food store that she had been having problems with her knee for a long time. Mm-hmm. And so we went there. And Dave blasted her, and I asked her, check it out. And she squatted down, and when she came back up, she had this really surprised look on her face that her knees weren't hurting.
Amen.
And then I saw her about a week later, and she told me her knees haven't felt that good since 2008.
Wow, that's a long time. Thank you, Jesus.
So then I asked her, and the lady Nancy, where we had the meeting in Lowell, uh-huh. I asked them if they wanted to get blasted. and they said, no, we have to work.
Oh, they didn't want to be shaken. Oh, that's funny. Oh, that's neat.
Yeah.
And I know you've ministered to some other people, and I don't know if you want to say names. You were at a friend's house, and then her daughter came, and you got to minister
yes.
to her daughter.
Yes. My friend Therese,
uh-huh.
She takes care of her grandson every week. And so then she had asked me to come over and be there when her daughter came to pick up her grandson. So when her daughter got there, we were just sharing with her testimonies and
Amen.
Just telling her about all the neat things we've seen God doing. And it wasn't very long, and she said, will you guys blast me? And before we did, she asked, do you need to know anything I'm having problems with? Mm-hmm. And I told her no.
Mm-hmm.
Holy Spirit knows exactly what to do.
Right.
So Therese took one hand, and I took the other one, and we blasted her at the same time,
mm-hmm.
and then we just waited. And about 30 seconds later, the tears started to flow.
Amen.
And then a few minutes later, I asked her, what's going on? And she said, I feel so light, like I'm floating. And then she told us she had had pain in her knee,
mm-hmm.
and I asked her to check it out. Mm-hmm. So she was moving around. The pain was completely gone. She had been having problems with her sinuses, and her sinuses were cleared.
Praise God.
Yeah.
Yeah. We just love seeing what God's doing. So.
And what did you do this weekend? You got to do some new things.
I got stretched way out of my comfort zone.
No.
No.
I had
a ball. I had the opportunity to, my first time to preach in a pulpit.
Praise
and
God.
I did the life show for you guys while you were gone.
Mm-hmm.
I hosted that, made a couple mistakes, and ended up starting early. But I lived with it. I figured it would be better for me to start it when I said I was going to start it than to not start it on time. So I stepped out in faith and just put a little bit more time into it.
But, amen.
It was a good experience for me, and
good.
I had a lot of fun doing it. And
good.
I look forward to more opportunities down the road. God seems to take us out of our comfort zone every once in a while. But,
yes.
It's a good
daily.
Thing, you know.
Yes.
It's a good thing to be stretched.
Oh, definitely.
It's an acceleration, and Curry mm-hmm. teaches on people that have the apostolic DNA, you're going to put people to work. It's just part of it. You're going to make people do things whether they like it or not. Jesus told you to go heal the sick whether mm-hmm. you liked it or not.
Yep.
If you actually read it in the Greek, it was a command.
Amen.
The other thing is, Butch has been ministering to people for years, and I'm just going to kind of do the highlights. I went up there. His mom and dad got healed and delivered, born again,
mm-hmm.
and they been filled with the Holy Ghost. He got ordained, and now he's preaching from a pulpit on a webcast show, all in 2 months.
Praise God.
And out of his own lips, he was getting less than 5% results before, and now he's in this 90-95.
It's...
Praise God.
So it's a short course, but when you hang around people that are getting results, you just get it. You can't really teach it. You got to kind of live with them for a little bit.
And that's why we do the training and we take people out and we do it out and about, because it's not just a classroom thing where you just sit and listen. You need to go get activated, go step out and do it. And so we're going to do it in the classroom setting, but then we want people to go out and about. You know, when you lay hands on somebody and you see their pain go from like torture, because they're in a lot of pain, to they're happy and they're excited. And it just like, wow. God, thanks for using me. It's pretty humbling when he does that.
What just happened to you? She just got touched. You can tell all of a sudden she'll get quiet.
Yeah.
I think it's funny.
Yeah, I'm not quite that often.
Well, what if somebody needs a word of knowledge? You know, like that lady Patty was showing that was really hurt. I just started reading her mail and it was setting her free.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't want to get in the details because some of them things are personal.
Mm-hmm.
God shows you some really personal things sometimes in the prophetic or words of knowledge. One of Patty's friends was really abused growing up. Really abused. I said, don't talk about it. We're just going to take authority over that. And it's going to be like, kind of like that Etch-a-Sketch. You shake it and it erases it.
Amen.
It really works that way. Next thing, they can see what happened to them. But it doesn't hurt no more. The hurt's gone.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. It says, the Bible says that Jesus carried your pains away. It wasn't just physical, that was the emotional pain that was something so deep that people can't figure it out only in the spirit. You know, like how did that work? Just like the person you just ministered to, all of a sudden she percolated for about 30 seconds. And like, I feel lighter. Well, that's something from the devil left you.
Right.
Not saying people are possessed, but they're oppressed to the devil. The devil's hurting them. And that's why psychologists and stuff can't figure it out, because they don't address the spiritual issue. Treatment centers don't address the spiritual, and that's why they never get them set free.
Yeah.
And I learned that from David Wilkinson. He was a young pastor, went to New York City, to the gang members there. He got them born again, filled with the Holy Ghost, had them praying for one another, and had an 80% success rate.
Praise God.
Why don't we do that again? Here's a recipe that
works
80% of the time for the hardest of the hard case gang members, drug addicts.
Yep.
And then we think we're smarter than God, and we put our brain in it again, and then our results go right down to...
2%, 3%, yeah. 5%.
Something that Dave says all the time. He says, how many pills did it take to cast out a devil? Well, it doesn't work.
People at our age, remember that Tootsie Roll commercial? How many licks does it take to get to the center of Tootsie Pop? You know, the world may never know. How many drugs did it take to cast out a devil?
Well,
the world may never know, because you can take them all and they won't.
It just needs somebody who knows what they're doing, somebody that believes in the Word of God, and somebody that does it, and just blast them out. They have to go. When you know who you are in Christ, you know you have the power and the authority, you can get the job done. And that's what we like to do, is get the job done, get people set free. And then they don't have to be on the medication. And we don't tell people what to do there, because that's not our job. God tells people what to do. And we tell them to ask God, because it's not up to us. So
it's a good thing.
we're not trying to get in trouble. We're just trying to do God's work. And that's what we do. So is there any other ones that you think of lately? You've been out and about praying for people
places? I think it was about a week ago. I took a friend out. We went to the mall, and she noticed a lady sitting in the food court. And we had been talking about different ways to approach people to start a conversation. And she noticed the lady had a bright pink walker. So that was how she started the conversation. But I loved it because the lady was so open and receptive,
yeah,
and let us blast her. And yeah, that was really cool.
Amen. So some of the other things we did this weekend, we got to minister at the end of the Tom Stammons meeting. And he's like, yeah, we need to do this more often. Yes, let the power of God be here. Let it flow through people. Let's see them healed and set free and just get doing God's work. You know, some people need to get set free before they can really go out there and do God's work. And so we actually had a home meeting at his house on Saturday night. And there was a young man there, Mark, that we'd ministered to him before. And he had pain, all kinds of pain. It's like he'd already gone to bed, but we came there about 10 o'clock at night and he got up. And so we got to minister to him and all the pain left his body. It was like at 8 and it was all gone. And he's like, nah, I think I can sleep good. I'm feeling real tired now. It's like, yes.
He got so tired he laid on the floor for a while.
Oh, well, that was the next night. Friday night, we blasted him and all the pain left. And then Saturday morning, Lila ministered to him again because it darn thing came back. And so blasted him and got it off of him again. And then when we got back Saturday night, it was there again. So we blasted it off of him again. And he ended up on the floor part of the night. And just holy laughter just hit him. And he was just giggling and giggling and giggling. I don't think I've ever seen him laugh before. And it just was so neat to see God move on him and just, you know, he's been through some junk, we all have, and just to see that stuff get knocked off of him and see him laughing the way he was.
Remember when I did the mint or the breath thing?
Yes.
I prayed over my cards. I said, we always pray over our cards. I just have people grab the cards. He was one of them that grabbed the cards, and that's what knocked him on the floor. Another guy, he just kind of went down behind the couch, boom, again.
Yeah, that was Charlie. He was shaking and baking. He's the one that's still shaking and baking. So, praise God. He got wrecked. Dave would blast him, and he was walking backwards and just like, where's the wall? Where's the wall? And he was just hugging on the wall and on the floor. I don't know how many times. He just kept coming back for more and more and more. Whatever God had for him, he wanted. He came with Matthew Goers. And Matthew, we just love him. He's a mighty man of God. And we were just blessed to be able to hang around with him again. And he brought Charlie and Matthew. He's walking in all this stuff.
Who's
too.
The other guy?
Which one?
The one that was on the floor rolling.
Oh, the prophet? I don't remember his name. And his wife. Oh, was it Dave?
No, it wasn't Dave.
We know so many Daves, so many Pastor Daves.
Was it Daryl?
Oh, I think so, yeah.
Anyway, I asked him how much he wanted, and I touched him. He just goes down, and I got down and started speaking in tongues in his belly, and he got wrecked. He was, like, doing crunches, and I can't do anymore. I said, looks like you can.
Yes.
Then he came and prophesied over me, grabbed my hand while he's prophesying. He just goes, boom, on the floor. I'm going to get through this.
He was going to give that message that God had for us no matter what. We might have to get some off your phone during the break. But he said, you guys are going to get some fancy sports car.
The Corvette with twin turbos. He said it goes 220 miles an hour.
I'm like, oh, I don't think we need to go that fast. Not that we'd mind if God blessed us with a car like that. But, yeah, we don't need to go that fast. And he said we're going to have vacation, too. It's like, okay, I received that in Jesus' name. And Dave had other people praying for us because, you know, when you honor a prophet, you get a prophet's reward. And so we had a lady, she come up and prayed for us, and you're going to go on a vacation, yeah, because she wanted one too. She caught on really quick. Oh, yeah, she had a voice of like an angel. Oh, my gosh, April. Wow, I just loved her voice. It just hit me. She's one of those anointed singers that really can wreck people and people can get healed, and just whatever they need, they can get when she sings. She sang at Tom's house and at the meeting too. So
it's like the lady that sings in our promo there. We've seen people get healed, delivered, born again, and actually filled with the Holy Ghost just because she's singing.
Amen.
And I think she's the fourth or fifth one now that we find people get healed, delivered, born again, and filled with the Holy Ghost. It's not just pretty music. Mm-hmm. It's the anointing that
right.
breaks the yoke.
Yep. Amen. Yep. I'm like, you know, we're going to have a seminar coming up in Illinois and Wisconsin, and we'd love to have you sing one of those. I can't remember. Are they from Wisconsin?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm not sure. Up by Green Bay. Somewhere in the Green Bay, Wisconsin area.
Yeah. So they weren't planning on staying overnight, but they did. And there was a couple other couples. The one that was Daryl and his wife, they stayed overnight. And then there was, Matthew and his friend Charles. They stayed till the end of our meeting Saturday night, which we kind of go kind of late sometimes.
Well, as long as God's moving, I don't want to be the one to tell God we got to go to bed.
No.
You can't minister anymore.
Well, we've got to go to a commercial. We'll be right back. Thank you.
Max Real Estate Concept Studios. This is Webcast One Live.
Chef D's Rock Power Pizza. We want to say God bless you and thank you. We're grateful to be able to give back to our community in so many ways. I'm the owner of Chef D's Rock Power Pizza, 4211 Southwest 9th in Des Moines, Iowa. And we're grateful by being able to close the doors every Monday to open it up to homeless and needy families in our community. We hopefully someday will be able to spread this to other cities so we can continue to show people love right where they're at. We're so grateful and so blessed because of God to be able to do this. We ask for your prayers. We ask for your donations financially, spiritually, and prayerfully, like I mentioned. We're grateful. There's so many hurting families today, and people pray for hope, and that hope comes through us because our hope is in Jesus Christ. And as Jesus lives through us, we ought to pour that hope out to other people so they may continue to believe and trust in Him. So we're thankful today. Again, this is Chef D from Chef D's Rock Power Pizza, 4211 Southwest 9th, and we're committed. I mean, sincerely committed to pouring into other people's lives, want nothing back but to see them be blessed by God. We thank you so much. And this is Chef D, and we're just grateful, and we ask for your prayers again. God bless you, and thank you.
I was hungry. I was thirsty. I was a stranger. I was naked. I was sick. To the least of these, Holy Spirit-led Ministries is a proud supporter of Impact Ministries International, changing the world together. Find out more at tstammen.com.
Hello, I'm Mike Politoski with Praise Broadcasting Network. For the finest in praise and worship music, visit us at www.pbnradio.com. We at PBN are proud supporters of Dave and Patty Logging, Holy Spirit-led Ministries, and we encourage you to prayerfully consider doing the same. You can visit their website at hslm.us and click the donate button and be a part of helping Dave and Patty reaching out to thousands of hurting people all across the United States of America. You know, the Great Commission of Jesus has no boundaries and no borders, and it takes enormous expenses to move a ministry like HSLM across the country. Would you like to be a part of it? We certainly would appreciate it. Join us in supporting Holy Spirit-led ministries by visiting www.hslm.us and click the donate button. Thank you and God bless you.
Hi, welcome back to Holy Spirit-led Ministries. And we've just been talking and I got sidetracked. But thank you, Jesus, for all you're doing. So, I don't know, Butch, do you have any other miracles that you've seen this week or testimonies that you want to share?
No, I've been kind of sticking close to the house there while you guys were gone and just trying to get over this little bit of chest congestion that I've been fighting against. I moved from one bedroom to another bedroom and just trying to stay busy.
Amen.
Well, you've been praying for people over the phone.
Yep.
And on the internet.
Yep. I admin on the Prayer Warriors of the World, so that's kind of...
So give us some success stories.
Well, there's a lot of people that on Prayer Warriors of the World that call up, and I blast them over the internet, typing, and I highlight the words life and light in my prayer, so that they can blast them, and I tell them, if this is for a loved one, pray over them until the pain's gone. Pray over them, And there's another testimony page for testimonies that when they are healed, you can go on and you can put your testimonies. And we've seen a few testimonies on there. This isn't about me. This is about the Lord doing the work and Amen. Doing the healing. And so I give God the glory. I don't like to, make it about me. I just, like to make it about Him. I just love being used by the hand of the Lord, and I love seeing the Lord work through me and through other people. And I'm honored to be a part of Dave and Patty's ministry to be able to go out and teach other people how to do this. And it's a humbling experience. I'm being touched here. I love it.
It's like we accelerate people, but it's like they're getting shot out of a rocket or a cannon. They've been doing praying all their life with very little results, and all of a sudden we fix them a little bit. Don't teach them anything new except, hey, it's this way, it's not that way, and they start getting results.
Release the kingdom. Amen.
We didn't really teach you anything new, except not to pray. Command.
Amen. Well, we have some prayer requests that we want to go over. And do you want me to start? Mm-hmm. And then, Nancy, whatever God lays on your heart, the Holy Spirit just prompts you to pray for. Or if you have somebody that you know that needs prayer, we'll just go ahead and do that. And then do you want to finish up or what?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Well, we just want to lift up the different ministries that we're involved with, and we just want to bless them and just see that, that they have all that they need. We just want to lift up Spiritual First Responders with Mike Politoski, IMI, Kingsway, Full Speed Impact, JGLM, HSLM, and we've got a couple people that, thank you, Maddie, Rock Tower Pizza, Chef D, yes. Mm-hmm. And I just want to lift up Dave's daughter and her family with their brand new baby girl, and my girlfriend Lynn with her daughter and their brand new baby girl. And just there was a lady that called earlier today, Lynn McCuckley. I don't know how to say your name. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. And then a friend of ours, Val, we just want to lift everybody up, and we just speak healing and wholeness over every one of you, and just blessings, and that God use you all in a mighty way.
Go ahead. I'm thinking about my friends back home who are beginning to step out, Therese, Mary Jo, Jamie, and I just pray a blessing on them that... Just in the name of Jesus, I just speak life over them and healing for Amen. All of them in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I just speak to anybody that's got neck or back trouble. There's so many of them people that have hurting necks, backs, things that they think the doctor, they're fused. I just be loosed and be whole in Jesus' name. We speak Amen. Life now.
Amen. And Maddie did find the other pictures. I just got them up on commercial break. Thank God for technology. Just a few pictures from Saturday night. Oh, Mark just got hit with the power of God and just was laughing and laughing and laughing. There's April in the background, the one that has a voice like an angel. And Mark's the one, he ended up on the floor just laughing under the power of the Holy Spirit. And then there's Charlie. Oh, my gosh. He just kept getting hit and getting wrecked. and just kept on the floor against the wall. He's the one that just kept coming back for more. He just wanted all that God had for him.
He looked like a puppet guy. He'd be there and then boom, he'd be on the ground. He'd climb back over the side again.
He'd be on the floor again. So we love to see God move and just whatever they need. You know, the Holy Spirit, He knows what they need, and He can get the job done. And so I want to encourage you, if you're in this area, every Tuesday and Saturday night, we have a meeting in our home. And if we're not there, like Butch, he filled in for us. Thank you, Butch. And we always have people that are there that they've gone through the training and they can get the job done. It's not Dave and Patty. It's just whoever that's been trained up, and they're just being a vessel that's being used by God. And, you know, we've got the Knapp family that's in this area, and they've got 9 kids, and every single one of them can walk in this. So it's not anybody special. It's just get out of the way and let God use you. So if you need any healing, come on Tuesday or Saturday night. If you want to walk in this, come and learn more about it. And we want to just encourage any pastors that if you've got people that are sick, just invite us. We'll come. And we'll see them healed. We don't think we're anybody special. We just are being used by God. And you want them to go through this training so they can all do it. We need more soldiers out there doing the work of the Lord, just going out and about and just getting this done. There's so many sick and hurting people everywhere you go. We were in the restaurant Sunday afternoon, and I like breakfast before I eat lunch, no matter what time it is. I like breakfast first. So we were going to go to a Subway, and their breakfast ended at 11 o'clock, and it was 11:05. And I was just a little bit annoyed. But I just said to the lady, do you know any other fast food place that we can have breakfast at? She goes, no, they're all done at 11 or before. So she told us to go to this other restaurant that was a couple exits down the road, which that was really kind of her, too, you know. And I asked her if she needed prayer for anything, and she said no. And I just put my hand out, and I just prayed a blessing over her. And she didn't want to let go of my hand. She had a hold of it, and she didn't want to let go. I'm like, whatever you need, just receive it. So that was neat. And so we went to this restaurant that she suggested. And it was really good food. They had a buffet breakfast, so I got my breakfast. Thank you, Jesus. And I just knew God was going to put somebody across our path that needed something. That's just the way He works. And He made me to want breakfast for a reason first. So anyhow, we had this waitress, and she said she had 3 jobs that she worked, and she was just exhausted. She was just tired. And she had pain. Do you remember where all the pain was?
I know her back was hurting.
Yeah, I know. I remember that too. But I know there was multiple things. And Dave just blasted her, and it was all gone. So we just know God puts us across people's path, and they're just divine appointments every day.
And they had the 5 food groups. They had bacon, ham, sausage link, sausage patty.
Yes, my Dave does like his meat.
Did you say carnivore?
Yes, very much so.
You know, most times they don't have both.
So she got what she needed, and we were blessed to be able to bless her. And today Nancy and I went to Costco's, and there was a young lady. As soon as we were walking in, she was walking out, and she just had this old tummy that you could tell she was due pretty quick. Mm-hmm. So I just said, oh, I'm a minister. I pray for pregnant ladies, and they don't have to go through labor pains. Could I pray for you? And she said, well, my husband's a minister. I said, okay, good. And I said, can I pray for you anyhow so you don't have labor pain? So I put my hand out, and she gave me her hand, and I prayed for her, and I just spoke a blessing over her, and that she have a good rest of her pregnancy and no pain, but she would know when she's in labor. The Holy Spirit touched him from the inside out. Whenever I see somebody, I do that. And so then I just, you know, went over and said hi to her husband and shook his hand and just gave him our card. So just divine appointments wherever we go. I want those babies to be born healthy and whole in Jesus' mm-hmm. name. So what else do you know today, honey?
Well, I know that we got a lot of things to catch up before the weekend. It got nice. The pool turned green. I started the pump running to kill the algae. And we were out in the sun all day. And it's not funny, but the sun doesn't really affect me much. Butch says, how do you do that? I said, I don't know. I've been doing it for a song. I just believe God protects me.
Amen.
If you watch me, I do some really wild, crazy things and like cut your finger half off of the saw, lay hands on it, and go right back to work with no wounds.
Amen.
Because last year, I was taking the nuts off my pickup and a thread was razor sharp and sliced into my finger. And we had Patty and another minister from Africa out there, and I'm dripping blood, drip, drip, drip. I said, watch this. It quit.
Amen.
I wiped it off of my pants, which is, cowboys do that. Patty don't know that yet, but and I looked, and it was almost all healed within minutes.
Yeah, I'm not a cowboy. I can't quite wipe my hands, my pants when they're bloody. Just not there.
It saves on Band-Aids and all the other techniques. It's a relationship. Do you know Jesus is your healer as much as your Savior? Do you know that He's your provider? Is He your protector?
Amen.
Does He take your pains away?
Yes, He sure does.
And this is why we're doing what we're doing. Anybody can read a book and teach you on the gifts. But He didn't say to teach them. He said to train them.
Amen.
There's a big difference. You know, anybody can tell you how to build a house. And we've had people. I said, well, how many houses you built? Well, none, but I could build a really good one. Well, when you build one, we'll see if your house is better than the ones I built mm-hmm. and the ones you built. You know, I've built them. We've done all the work from the ground all the way to the ceiling. I think Butch has done that. And you can tell him, you know, he's built a house. Hey, he knows what he's doing that. And that's what we've lost mm-hmm. in the ministry. People actually get results.
Amen.
You wouldn't do that in any other form of business. Do you go to the mechanic that never fixes your car? Just tell you, well, I read a book really good on it, but I've never fixed a car in my life. And, oh, just keep paying me. We got to get results. Jesus required results. He required it of the first 12, the next 70, and all.
Amen. Yeah, we want to get people activated in doing all the work of the Lord because there's so much more to do. And we want to see them step into it. We want to see them walk it out. We want to see them get people saved, healed, people set free. Bring them back from the dead if needed. Whatever they need. We want them to be equipped to be able to walk in all of it.
Was that God's idea or our idea?
That was God's idea.
He told the first 12, go heal the sick, raise the dead, cast out devils. He told the next 70 to go heal the sick, raise mm-hmm. the dead, and cast out devils. He said, all believers... Now, you teach them what I taught you.
Mm-hmm.
So quit reading between the lines. Just read the words that are there. Go busy.
Amen. Yeah, just like a friend of ours, he had a friend of his look at our website, and he goes, you know what? He was a prophet. He said, looks like somebody's actually believing the Bible and doing it. Yes. Yes. We need more people out there believing the Bible and doing the work of the Lord. There's not enough people that are out there in the marketplace, getting people saved, healed, and set free. And we just want to train up more soldiers. A friend of ours saw a vision, and she saw us training up people. And it was like watering plants all over a garden. And they grew up into soldiers. They had on, like, fatigues on. So that's what we're doing.
And swords in their hand.
Yeah.
What was I busy doing?
You were talking to Jesus. That'd be a good place to be.
It's kind of a good thing to do that, so you make sure you're on the right channel.
Yes, amen. Well, our time's about out, so we want to thank you for being with on the show. We want to thank Nancy and Butch and Maddie, our producer, and all those people that give into the ministry. We couldn't do it without you. We love doing the work of the Lord for all the peoples that donate into our ministry. And we just want to keep doing God's work wherever we are and seeing people saved, healed, filled, and delivered. And we just thank all of the people that are close by that help us do the work on the home front. And most of all, we want to thank God, because God is the one that makes it all possible. So thank you, God. And we will see you next week, same time, same place. God bless.